I was never part of a scene where I was the leader of a bunch of Jewish girls that sung jazz, you know what I mean? I don't know anyone like myself.
Amy Jade Winehouse was born into an extremely tight-knit Russian-Jewish family on September 14, 1983. Her father, Mitch, was a taxi driver. Her mother, Janice, a pharmacist.
When I was cute, until the age of about 5, then I got naughty. I was very naughty, very, very naughty.
A gregarious child growing up in the North London suburbs, she was always set on a life in show business. Amy even wrote about it when she was just 12 years old.
I want people to hear my voice and just forget their troubles for 5 minutes.
As a teen, she was strong-willed. Acting out often, she bounced around from school to school, taking a liking to tattoos, piercings, and pubs, all the while channeling her feelings into her music.
You know, I've been through times where I've been so f***ed up about a situation that I've had to just be like, write everything down, you know, even feelings that I don't want to acknowledge.
The tears she cried, however, were not shed in vain. By the end of her teens, Amy landed her first record deal.
Well, the thing is with the music is I really pushed myself with the album on all levels.
In 2006, with the release of her second album, Back to Black, Amy's dreams of superstardom were coming true. She didn't just sound different, she looked different too. Her now famous beehive hairstyle, Cleopatra cat eyeliner, and old school tattoos.
I never played.
In 2008, Amy won a remarkable 5 Grammys, including Record and Song of the Year. But her talent was eclipsed by her troubles. She struggled with addiction, alcohol, and drugs. Her family tried to get her help time and time again. Tried to get Amy to help herself.
And my greatest fear is probably dying with no one knowing of any contribution I'd ever made to creative music.
Millions of fans now mourn her, the terrible waste of so much talent. Millions miss her music, her magic, her sly sense of humor.
Have they tried to mold you in any way, though, if people ask you to do things to change the way you look or speak or behave?
Yeah, one of them tried to mold me into a big triangle shape, and I went, no!
Amy Winehouse was just 27 years old when she died. For her fans, for her family, the loss, the love will never fade away.
No greater love than what I feel for you. What I feel for you.
So much talent. I want to welcome Amy's parents, her father Mitch, and her mother Janice here. And it's a dumb question, but how are you holding up?
We're heartbroken, but we're doing okay. We're doing okay. You know, we have our foundation, we have each other, we have our wonderful family and friends, and, you know, and people like you.
Yeah.
And we're doing okay.
We're going to obviously talk about what happened to her in those final days. But before we get to that, I really just want to kind of get a sense from you of what she was like. Did you know from a young age that she had this remarkable talent?
I think Janice had a better idea than I had.
Yeah. Is that right? Yes. What about it? Why?
Because she just sang all the time.
All the time, really?
All the time, yeah. And we'd
from
say,
what age?
Amy, shut up. From, like, as soon as she could, like, talk and sing.
Uh-huh. And you listened to Frank Sinatra, you listened to jazz. That clearly influenced her.
Well, definitely, you know, we'd sing the songs together. I mean, she loved music.
In some of the videos I've seen, it looks like she's fighting, which she was kind of rambunctious from a very young age.
Yeah, she was spirited.
Spirited.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
She was a naughty little girl. Yeah. I mean, but in a nice way. She was she was very sweet.
Oh, yes.
Very sweet and very affectionate and loved kisses and cuddles, as she did right throughout her life.
At what point did you start to think, okay, the singing's not just annoying, she's actually really talented?
No, I think it was a case of we just helped her take it further. And that's what we did.
You know, it's a funny thing. We went to see her. She got a scholarship for Sylvia Young when she was about 14.
And which is a school for talented kids.
Yes. Yeah, but she got the scholarship for dancing and acting.
Yeah.
And she, the first year, she said, we're doing a show, Dad.
and I'm singing, and I said, singing? Anyway, so we went to see the show, and whether the song was in the wrong key for her, I don't know, but the song wasn't, she didn't sing the song well. Mm. I remember saying, thank God she can dance, because she can't sing. And in the following year, she said, Dad, I'm singing again. And I went, oh, my God, she's singing again. So we went to see her the next year. She was about 15 then. And all of a sudden, she could sing. So that's when I had the indication that she was...
That there was...
There was certainly something else going on.
You two divorced when she was how old?
10.
When she was 10.
Yeah, I left the house when I was 10.
But you stayed very in close contact for her.
Absolutely. We're very close.
Oh, yes.
There's a video that we found of Amy in the back of a cab when she's 18, before she's hit it big.
Right.
That's really... Not my cab.
It's not your cab. No, you're a cab driver. When I first saw it, I thought it was your cab, but... I just want to show our viewers that, because she's so youthful and just so full of excitement.
I think I've seen it.
Yes, and appreciation.
My name is Amy.
Amy who?
Amy Winehouse.
You're going to be a top singer, yeah?
I don't know.
You sung today?
I didn't sing it today.
But you wrote today?
I think it's called We Both Know.
We Both Know? Okay, I look forward to hearing it. So, Amy, you bought a nice guitar today, yeah? Let's have a look. Oh, yes. Is that your first guitar?
No, it's my third guitar.
Third guitar. You're going to be strumming away tonight?
Tonight, yes. I've got to finish the song.
OK. Amy, been very nice to have you as my customer.
What's your name?
Russ. Thanks for the tip. Here's your receipt. And, my tip to you is stay cool, because you're very cool.
Thank you.
Cheers. Bye-bye.
You've never seen that before. What's it like seeing that?
I've never seen it before. It's wonderful.
Yeah.
Can I have a copy?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah. That's right.
I know.
What do you see in her there? I mean, is that the Amy you remember from that time?
Well, it was the Amy that I remember from that time, and it was the Amy that I remember from always. That's exactly how
that's her.
She was. That's it in a nutshell.
Definitely.
Just a normal kid. Wonderfully generous, normal kid.
Why was it important for you to talk? To be here today?
Well, there are a number of reasons. The most important reason is for the foundation.
The Amy Winehouse Foundation?
Yeah. We are hoping to raise money. We will raise money for disadvantaged children suffering with drug abuse, ill health. In the UK, as it is in the US, I'm sure there are for children and juveniles, the services are sadly lacking.
How important have her fans been in helping you through this?
It's just I was in New York. I came back. I was in a daze. I went straight to Amy's house. They wouldn't let her in. They wouldn't let me in the house, but she was still in there. And I went across the street to speak to the fans. There were hundreds of fans, and they just they just picked us up.
Yeah, they were lovely.
They just cuddled us.
Yes. No.
It's very difficult for me, but it was one of the most, in the most tragic of times, it was the most wonderful experience that I think I've ever had in my life.
Yeah.
Wonderful.
Yes, it was. And when we stepped out of the house at one time, people came up to me and they thanked me for having Amy. I mean, that's when I knew, I mean, this is something else. To be thanked for giving birth to my child. It's wonderful.
And that helps you?
Oh, yes, yes.
We're going to have a lot more with Amy's family when we come back. We're going to take a short break. When we come back, we'll also meet her aunt and later on her boyfriend, Reg. We'll be right back.
All news is good news, and if one person reads the paper and thinks, what? She punched who? She said what? And goes, she must be mad. I'm going to buy her album. She must be quite cool because she's nutty. If one person does that, then cool.